menteri kata nak lupa pek jaka mariang ujim sama ura let gendu ya shipau teli kishnong ki baha papo ri boy district ban sumar ya kamai mariang. Ujim sama ura pen sengau tu ru ya kinong ya lam shnong bat kipat ba nong shong shnong jung gini ki shipau teli kishnong kumno ban sumar ko ya kamai mariang am ban brat pathar ya ki jaklia sha klau sha betap bat am day ban pom pathar ki dieng ki set bat day ban thung bujili ru ya ki dieng ban penne pensa ya kajing itenat kamariang knang ban yo ya kajing kot kajing kia da ka ba yo ban ring da ka le er ka ba khut ha ka ju ka por Ulaong baka surok ka di ka bot lum jong ka shenong ka thao ka ban pensuk ya ka yaad ka yeng ki paad ba but unsa pensngaw ya ka ne sha u menteri u ba pek ya ka tenat PWD.
Now only once a year that you being able to grow your agriculture products and harvest it. It is affecting the livelihood and it's very unfortunate but you know that this is something that all of us are living with right now. The bigger problem is, as we all know, something called climate change. And climate change is affecting the entire planet. It's affecting everyone. And I think it's everyone's duty, including you and me and the future generation. We have to teach them, we have to sensitize them about the reality that climate change is. It is very real. Many people say that it is nothing, but it is very real. As you have seen, there is no less rainfall. As you can see nowadays, the temperature has gone up. So what happens is that even 1 degree of temperature difference, say suppose you have been living in this really nice place where you've never had to use fans, you've never had to, use AC. And in such a place where you have 1 degree of change in temperature also, it affects the plant species, It affects agricultural production, even a 1 degree difference. So, a lot of people may say climate change is nothing serious, but it is affecting everyone. And today, in Garo Hills, for example, we have hailstorm and it is so unpredictable. So every March, April, there's hailstorms and then it destroys crops. We have thunderstorms which these are like cyclones which come and blow away the rooftops of houses and destroy crops also. So all these things are happening and it is a reality, but many people still think that it's nothing because it's slowly that effect takes place. First of all, having me here, it's indeed an honor for me to be sitting here in this Gram Sevak circle with 15, how many villages?
18. In Maulidap Gram Sevak circle, there are 18 villages.
18 villages, and of course the other headmen and Ramashankar are here, and secretaries are here. As I said, I may be Minister of Government of Meghalaya as holding the portfolio of forest and power and law, other departments are there. But today I'm not here as a minister, I'm here as a fellow administrator, if I may call it. All of you also are administrators and I felt that this would be a great opportunity to share ideas, to understand what the real grassroots issues are and the challenges are. And today, really, for me, I feel very honored to be present here amidst all of you. Bajinu, what you mentioned just now is, I think, a problem that is not just confined to your area, but it is all over the state, probably all over the world, where agriculture, which is purely dependent in the absence of technology, purely dependent on rainfall. And today you have entered into this cycle where because of lack of rainfall, you are resorting to cutting down trees for charcoal and for other purposes. And because you cut down trees, that is going to affect the delicate you know, ecological balance, as they call it. And therefore, again, it will affect the rain water cycle. So it becomes this cycle into in which you become, you know, you are drawn into it, and it's very difficult to then come out of it. So it's so true that your problems are there, I understand. And we are a young government right now, and we are all very young leaders in, as you know, in Meghalaya, MLAs and ministers. And we are really pushing for new ideas in terms of how we can solve these problems, which are small in nature, but then in the future they'll become very, very big, and finding a solution to those big problems will be difficult. So it is now that we feel we must step in and we must start acting. And this is something that I feel that we can find a solution to this. There are many solutions which we can take the help of technology also. But we want to find out solutions which are ecological solutions, which will at least help in finding, solutions to the problem, which will help in bringing up the economy, and at the same time protect the environment. So, in terms of rain, the shortage of rain and all these issues that you have.
So I'm very happy to be here at Molandep village at the invitation of the Thum Ying Day. This is a group of the Rangpashnongs of 18 villages which are around, in and around Molandep. And it's been a really great interaction that I've had with the Rangpashnongs, the secretaries and leaders of these 18 villages today. There are many points that the leaders have mentioned in the due course of my interaction today with them. And these are regarding livelihood issues, regarding infrastructure issues of the village, and also I have had a chance to discuss many other important issues like the environment, especially in relation to climate change, and also regarding the COVID-19 situation. And this has been a great enlightening and very insightful experience for me to have interacted, wherein many points have come up as even as suggestions by the leaders of these villages, by Rangpashnongs and secretaries. And today I'd like to lay stress on the discussion on climate change and on the environment. It's really heartening to see that there is so much awareness among the people of this village and the surrounding village when it comes to issues relating to the environment and issues relating to climate change. The awareness is there about the kind of ill effects of certain activities which are taking place here, but the helplessness is something that really touches me, because of lack of infrastructure. Many of these villages are left with no choice but to go for environmentally harmful activities like felling of trees for charcoal and other things like that. So it is very important for us as a government to